Hello listeners, I am Dr. Anuj Kumar Sharma, working in Center for Advanced Studies, which is in campus institute of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University, Lucknow. So, in this lecture we will discuss the introduction to IC engines in continuation to the previous lecture. In that lecture we discussed the different classification of IC engines, and we were discussing the different components of engine. So, in this lecture we will discuss the different terminology used in IC engine in continuation to the different components. Then we will discuss the four strokes of IC engines. We have four strokes in IC engines, so we will discuss one by one. Then we will have a discussion on construction and working of two and four stroke engines. Stroke means IC engines, we will talk about only IC engines. So, then difference between two stroke and four stroke, and followed by the difference between SI and CI engines. SI means spark ignition, CI means compression ignition, and then we will discuss a little bit about the scavenging process. So, what does it mean, we will discuss. So, we are discussing this components of IC engines. So, we have different components of these engines. So, in the important is cylinder in which the combustion takes place, then piston which reciprocates inside the cylinder, then there is one member, that is the connecting rod. So, this is the connecting rod, and piston and connecting rods are getting connected with the help of gusset pin. So, it is important. So, it is gusset pin, then this connecting rod is connecting to the crank pin, to the crank. So, this is the crank. So, this connecting rod and crank, it is connected with the crank pin. So, it has 1 degree of freedom, means only the rotation, and this is the rotation of crank. So, it means with this assembly we are converting the reciprocating motion of the piston inside the cylinder into the rotary motion of the crank. So, this is the mechanism by which we generally convert the reciprocating motion into the rotation, and it is the 4-bar mechanism basically. And this is the the portion where the oil is filled just to have proper lubrication inside the cylinder, and this is the suction while suction stroke the air or air fuel mixture comes inside the engine cylinder, and after the burning and release of energy it goes out from the exhaust port. So, these are important components of the IC engine. It has the spark plug also for IC, for SI spark ignition. Generally, we fuel the we burn the fuel inside the cylinder. So, where we use the spark plug, just like the gas lighters in our kitchen, where we generally produce the spark to get the stove on. So, now we will discuss different terminology which we generally use in the IC engines. So, first is the cylinder bore. So, cylinder bore means I have already discussed this. So, let us say this is the cylinder, right. So, this is circular in shape. So, the diameter of this cylinder, so the nominal or inner diameter of the working cylinder. So, this is the working cylinder. So, the diameter of this is bore. Generally, it is known as the cylinder bore. So, there are some parameters which we should have in our mind while doing numericals or while in understanding the different terminologies. Second is the piston area. So, this is the area of circle of diameter equal to the cylinder bore. So, the area of circle of diameter equal to the cylinder bore. So, this is the, let us say if we see this cylinder from the top. So, we will see like this. So, the area of this piston. So, if you see, this is the cylinder, inside the cylinder this we have the piston. So, the top area of this piston, that is known as the piston area. Stroke, the nominal distance through which a working piston moves between two successive reversals of its direction of the motion. So, as already we have discussed, so let us say this is the, you know, cylinder, and inside this, this is the piston connected with the connecting rod. It moves up and it moves down. So, there are two points. It goes up to this particular point and it comes back, and then it comes to this position and it goes up. So, these two positions are, this is known as the top dead center, this is known as the bottom dead center. So, the distance traveled by this piston between TDC and BDC, this distance, this is known as the stroke, sorry, L here. So, this is known as the stroke. So, it is the stroke length. So, if we talk about the two stroke engine, it means for completing one cycle, the piston travels two stroke, it goes up and comes down. But four stroke engines, for completing one cycle, it has to travel four strokes. So, from BDC, it goes to TDC 1, or TDC to BDC 1, BDC to TDC 2, TDC to BDC again 3, BDC to TDC again 4. So, like this, to complete one cycle, it has to travel four strokes. So, that is why it is known as a four stroke engines. Next is the dead center. So, these are the dead centers we have already talked about. The position of the working piston and the moving parts, which are mechanically connected to it at the moment, when the direction of the piston motion is reversed at either end point of the stroke. So, like I have shown you in the previous. So, this is the TDC and this is the BDC. So, when the piston is moving up, so, at this particular position, the velocity was upward, but when this piston reaches this position, the velocity just reversed to this direction. So, reversal of the direction of the motion of the piston takes place. So, this is the dead center. So, we have two dead centers. One is the bottom dead center and another one is the top dead center. Sometimes, in case of horizontal engine, so this is the vertical engine. So, if we talk about the you know, the horizontal engine, so horizontal engine seen like this. So, let us say this is the, you know, cylinder, inside this, this is a piston, it reciprocates like this and like this. So, this is the, it should be TDC and it should be BDC, but here both the centers are at the same horizontal level. So, we cannot say that in them TDC and BDC. So, this is the, you know, the cylinder crankcase. So, inside this, let us say this is the you know, connecting rod, it is connecting with the help of this brake shaft with the crank, this is the crank. So, it goes down, it rotates. So, in this particular case, or in case of horizontal engines, we call this point as IDC and this point as ODC. So, what does it mean? So, IDC means inner dead center and ODC means outer dead center. So, it means in case of vertical engines, the BDC and in case of horizontal engine, IDC are same. So, BDC becomes IDC and TDC becomes ODC. So, outer means it is outside of the crank and IDC means it is inside, yeah, towards the crank. So, that is why it is known as IDC. So, at dead centers, the position, the piston's velocity becomes 0, because the direction of the velocity is reversed at a particular movement. So, it means when the piston is exactly at TDC or BDC or IDC or ODC, it will have the 0 velocity. So, next is the displacement volume or swept volume. It is very important parameter. So, this is equal to A into L. So, this is the piston, this is the cylinder, inside this the piston reciprocates. So, what does it mean, displacement volume? So, this is the TDC and this is the BDC, and the distance between the TDC and BDC is what? It is the stroke length. So this is L, and what is the, if you'll see this cylinder from the top. So this area is A. So what is the volume which is being swept by the cylinder while moving from top dead center to the bottom dead center? So this is the volume. This is the volume. And how we can calculate this volume? This volume is length multiplied by the area. Area is A. So the displacement volume or swept volume will be equal to the product of area and stroke length. Now next is the clearance volume. So it is the nominal volume of the space on the combustion side of the piston at the top dead center. So you can see here, this is the upper wall of the cylinder, where generally the valves are fitted or the inlet port is there. So it means we have to provide some clearance so that the top portion of the piston does not collide with the walls, right. So we generally keep some distance. So this is known as the clearance length, and this volume is known as the clearance volume. So what is the advantage of having this clearance volume? If we will not have clearance volume, then it will not be easy for us to compress the air. So we need some, you know, initially let us say the piston was here, so it will have this much of volume, total volume this much. Now when we will move this piston upward, so what will happen to the air or mixture which is already filled inside the cylinder? It will be compressed and piston will move up to this location. So whole mixture will be compressed to this particular position, this clearance length. So this is the clearance volume. So clearance volume is lower than the swept volume. So it means now we have three types of volumes. One is the total volume. So total volume means, let us say Vt is equal to Vc means clearance volume, this C, and plus swept volume. So this is the swept volume. So we have three types of volume. So total volume means the volume inside the cylinder when the piston reaches the bottom dead center, and clearance volume means the volume remaining in the cylinder when the piston reaches the top dead center. So it is the nominal volume of the space on the combustion side, means this is the combustion side. So on this side the remaining volume is clearance volume. So it is generally represented by Vc. Now the total volume of cylinder we have already discussed. Now the compression ratio, it is very important parameter. Compression ratio is generally represented by R, and it is the ratio of swept volume to the compression volume, clearance volume, sorry, clearance volume. So initially the we have swept volume and this is the clearance volume. So the ratio of these two volumes is known as the compression ratio. And if you will see, let us say for petrol engine the compression ratio is something lower than the compression ratio for the CI engines, compression ignition engines. So for diesel engines it is around 21 or 18 to 21, and for petrol engines it is near about 12 to 14. So it means that is why the diesel engines are heavy as compared to petrol engines. So now we will discuss the different strokes of the IC engine, because I was talking about the four strokes. So we have these four strokes: suction stroke, compression stroke, combustion and expansion stroke, or in short it is also known as the power stroke, and next is the exhaust stroke. So generally in a complete cycle of one cycle of the engine, we have four strokes. So initially what happens actually? So now you are aware about the different components of the engine. So here we can see the different valves, spark plug, piston, cylinder, crankcase, every part is known to us now. Now let us say before the entry of fluid, some motion starts inside the cylinder with the help of battery which we have, or generally in the case of vehicles when we do not have the battery, we generally kick off the engine to start. So, in first stroke what we do? Generally, we get the suction of the air or air plus fuel. Like in case of petrol, let us say we have clear cut explanation. In case of petrol engines, air plus petrol mixture comes inside the cylinder. But in case of diesel engine, only air is sucked inside the engine cylinder and we compress it and then we spray the diesel using MPFI and various technologies, multi-point fuel injection and injectors, different technology we use to supply the diesel. So, let us talk about the suction stroke. So, in suction stroke, this air fuel or air mixture or air gets sucked inside the engine cylinder while piston moving down from TDC to BDC. So, just like the injection syringe, what we do? We pull the plunger down. If we insert the needle into the medicine bottle and we pull the piston of the syringe. So, it sucks some fluid inside the cylinder due to the pressure difference. So, same methodology takes place here. The air fuel mixture or air gets sucked inside the cylinder in the first stroke and piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center. So, this is the first stroke, and while this stroke, this inlet valve is opened. You can see here it is opened. So, this fuel or air mixture or air gets entered into the cylinder, and at this time the exit valve or outlet valve is closed. You can see here. So, no supply of or no exit of fuel takes place. So, this is the first stroke. The piston has traveled one stroke length and the fuel has entered into the cylinder. Now, both the valves are closed. This is closed, this is closed, and piston moves up. So, now it is a case when you stop the needle or an exit point of the syringe and you push the plunger. What will happen? So, you will feel high pressure on your palm. So, it means or thumb, it means the air or air fuel mixture which was entered during the suction stroke will be compressed here now to a high pressure, and while compressing at a higher pressure it will be heated, it will get the temperature of this mixture will become more and more. So, we will go to the higher value of temperature. So, this is the compression stroke. So, we are compressing the air fuel mixture. So, this is a compression. Now, as soon as it reaches the top dead center, what happens? The temperature of air fuel mixture reaches up to that particular point where if we give the spark to the air fuel mixture, compressed air fuel mixture with the help of this spark plug, what will happen? Just like in the case of our kitchen, when we light or give the spark to the LPG, what happens? It gets ignited at a moment suddenly. So, an explosion takes place here due to this spark plug, and this burning of fuel takes place instantly, and this because of the these two valves are closed. So, what will happen? See, it will not have any possible movement except the downward motion of this piston. So, it will push the piston down. So, and the piston will start moving down. So, this is known as the combustion expansion stroke, or popularly we known, we call it as power stroke, because we are getting the power. So in this stroke we get the power. So piston goes down, so it is expanding, the gases are expanding inside the cylinder, and we are getting the power. Where we are getting the power? With the help of this connecting rod, Gussen pin and all these things at the shaft, which is this shaft perpendicular to this board. So this shaft will start rotating. So here we are getting the power stroke. And now what happens? So when the piston reaches the bottom dead center, the whole cylinder compartment is filled with the burned charges. So there is almost smoke and burned charges. So now what we have to do next? We have to take out the burned charges out from the cylinder, out from the cylinder, just to you know, take these gases out. So that is the last stroke, where this valve will be open, this is closed, and the burnt charges will come out of this cylinder. So this is the exhaust stroke. So it means now we again will come to this stroke. So it means the piston has traveled 4 times, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So just to make the cycle complete, so piston, so in this we have you know, the moved the piston 4 times, so it is the 4-stroke engine. So just for completing one cycle, the piston has traveled 4 stroke of length. Now what is the 2-stroke IC engine? So in case of 2-stroke, we do not have any valves, we have ports. Here you can see, you can also Google the, you know, the different sites where you can see the animations also. So how stuff works, or if you will type in Google the animation of the engines, of animation of the 2-stroke engine. So when you will type in the Google box, you will get different animations, and you can see how actually the fuel is getting inside the cylinder, it is getting compressed, then burned, then coming out of the cylinder. So you can see the complete process through animation. So that will be more easy for you to understand the working of 2-stroke and 4-stroke engines. So this is the 2-stroke engine. In this what happens? So no piston stroke for suction and exhaust operations. So it means we have reduced the strokes. So in 4-stroke engines, the process which we were doing in 4 strokes, now we are doing the same process in 2 strokes. So in this case, this is the first case, and this is not case, this is the first and the second part of the cycle. So in this first case, first cycle, what is happening actually? The piston is coming down. So because of this piston, the gases which were filled here, so they were be moving in this direction, and the burnt charges which is already there in the cylinder, it is going out. So you can see the exhaust gases or exhaust stroke that is taking place here. The transfer of the gases are coming to this particular portion. Now if we will understand the second cycle first, then we will be able to understand the first cycle easily. So here what is happening? So it is going up, compressing the charges which are already transported to this particular position. So here we have the burnt charges by yellow, and orange, pink color is showing the fresh charge. So fresh charge is pushing the burnt charges out, so it is coming out, and the space is being filled with the help of fresh charge. Now here the fresh charge, you can see the fresh charge, this is getting compressed while the piston moving up, and simultaneously, so when it is moving up, the fresh petrol plus air mixture is getting inside into through the inlet port. So this is the exhaust port, this is the inlet port. So here you can see this inlet port is closed, But here this inlet port, while the piston is moving up, the inlet port is opened and the exhaust port is closed. So, in this process, second half of the cycle, the fresh charge is coming into the crankcase portion and burning is taking place simultaneously on the upper part of the cylinder. So, here we have done, we have combined the the strokes together, and we have eliminated the exhaust stroke and the suction stroke. So, we are having only two strokes here. So, for completing one cycle, the piston is reciprocating from top to bottom and from bottom to top. So, this is the complete cycle of the two stroke engine. So, in two strokes, you can see here we do not have any oil, lubricating oil. So, generally if you remember in previous days, what we used to do? We used to mix the 2T oil or lubricating oil along with the petrol in two stroke engines. If you have any old scooters or old vehicle, you might have remember that we used to mix 2T oil with the petrol. But in case of four stroke engines, we generally do not do this. What we do? We fill the engine oil inside the crankcase while having the service of our engine, and we use only the neat oil, neat petrol in the fuel tank. Then we, with the help of carburetor, we prepare the air and fuel mixture, and then accordingly we use the burning of the fuel. So, now I think you are able to understand the different components of the IC engine, different classification of IC engine, and now you can differentiate the two stroke and four stroke engines. So, you can see in two stroke engine we are getting the power alternatively after every stroke, and in case of four stroke engines we get the power in the fourth stroke. It means 1/4 stroke we are getting the power. So, here you can now understand the difference between two stroke and four stroke. So, in next lectures we will discuss more about the engines. Thank you listeners for having patience and listening this lecture. So, thank you so much.